On a dark night at San Francisco International Airport, four aircraft loaded with passengers were waiting for their turn to take off. Suddenly, they noticed a plane rapidly approaching for landing. The incoming plane requested landing permission from ATC, which was granted. At first, the pilots of the four aircraft thought it might be a misunderstanding and expected the incoming plane to align itself with the empty runway as it got closer. However, things were not as they expected. The landing aircraft was heading straight for them. This terrifying incident wasn't very old. On July 7, 2017, Air Canada Flight ACA-759 took off from Toronto Pearson International Airport with 135 passengers and 5 crew members. It was a routine flight scheduled to land at San Francisco International Airport in 5 hours and 30 minutes. The pilots, both highly experienced and having landed at San Francisco Airport several times before, were not expecting an ordinary day. This day was about to become a significant example in the aviation industry. The journey was smooth until Air Canada 759 approached San Francisco and started to position for landing, waiting for permission from the air traffic control tower. San Francisco Airport has 4 runways, but only 2 can be operated at a time. If the wind comes from the south, 2 of the runways are used for landing and takeoff, and if the wind comes from the west, the other 2 are used. It's known that planes take off and land against the wind. On that day, the wind was from the west, so one of the runways, either 28 liters or 28R, was to be used for landing against the wind. However, things started to go wrong. Runway 28 liters was closed for maintenance and its lights were off. The control tower directed Air Canada 759 to land on the adjacent runway 28R. As the pilots had landed at this airport several times before, they expected to see 2 parallel lights of the runway, with the intention to land on the right one. This was their first mistake. On either side of these runways are 2 taxiways marked with green lights, where planes loaded with passengers from the terminal make their way to the runway. But in the night's darkness, the pilots of Air Canada 759 mistook the lights of the taxiway for runway 28R and the actual lights of 28R for 28 liters. Unknown to the pilots, an even greater danger loomed. 4 fully loaded planes were waiting on the right taxiway to take off. 3 were United Airlines planes, and 1 was a Philippine Airlines plane. Together, they had more than 1,000 passengers, and their fuel tanks were fully loaded. There's only a 100-meter distance between runway 28R and the taxiway, making it difficult for the control tower to discern where Air Canada 759 was actually landing. The question arose, why weren't the pilots informed about the closure of runway 28 liters for maintenance, a routine matter? Had they known, this confusion wouldn't have arisen. The closure was mentioned in the NOTAMs, Notices to Airmen, which contain information from takeoff to landing, usually spread over many pages. Identifying key notices isn't always easy, leading to the pilots missing the notice about 28 liters. This was their second major mistake. Air Canada 759 was rapidly approaching what they believed to be the runway. The control tower had given them permission for a visual approach, which means the pilots needed to manually align the plane with the runway. Under clear weather conditions, the visual approach is typically authorized. However, since pilots have previously misjudged during visual approaches, resulting in landings at wrong locations, they often rely on the instrument guidance system during such approaches. This system informs pilots whether they are correctly aligned with the runway until the very end. This system must be manually activated by entering the runway number, especially in an Airbus A320 like Air Canada 759. However, for some reason, the pilots didn't activate it, marking their third mistake. The pilots were making one mistake after another. Both pilots had a long day. It was 11:45 p.m., and they hadn't had much rest in the past 19 hours. Canadian pilot fatigue rules weren't very strict at the time. So we've identified 3 mistakes made by Air Canada 759's pilots, But what about the four planes that were watching Air Canada not aligning with the runway but with the taxiway, and still not reporting it to the control tower? It's common for planes to approach a bit more from the right during visual approaches at San Francisco Airport. If a plane comes directly in line with 28R, it would have to fly over Foster City in San Francisco, causing noise pollution. Therefore, pilots typically align themselves with the runway as they get closer. For the pilots of the four parked planes, this was normal, which is why no one reported it to the control tower. The control tower replied that 28R was empty and that they were cleared to land. The tower also didn't realize that the plane was about to land on the taxiway. Usually, another controller monitors ground traffic, but since it was a time of night with less traffic, only one controller was managing everything. The pilots of the planes waiting in line, listening to the conversation between Air Canada 759 and the control tower, were also confused as to why Air Canada wasn't aligning with the runway even when close. In the final seconds, when it became clear that Air Canada was mistaking the taxiway for the runway, the pilots of the first United Airlines plane immediately informed the control tower without giving their call sign. In response, the control tower immediately relayed a go-around message to Air Canada. By the time Air Canada received the message, they were just a few feet above the third plane in line. Fortunately, they reacted quickly, pulling up the lever to gain altitude. Had there been a delay of just one more second, it would have been one of the biggest disasters in aviation history, with 1,000 passengers on the parked planes and 135 on Air Canada, all with fully loaded fuel tanks. After the incident, a full investigation was conducted, revealing that the pilots of Air Canada 759 were at fault for not activating the instrument guidance system and for missing the NOTAMs. Additionally, the National Transportation Safety Board established new rules for San Francisco Airport, stating that when one runway is closed, visual approach permission will not be given. Also, it became mandatory to have a ground traffic controller during off-peak hours.